Yeah, done. Okay.
I'm gonna do it this time.
Get her. Oh, she's here. So he's not fighting against her. They're seeing who can get the better score against VI opponents. Of course, you have to move a little more. That's it? Did I... That's it. Alright. Let's look around. These are all his... Well, we got a little Elton John over here. All these sunglasses. All different colors. Packet. Delicata squash. Cultivated for low gravity. 88% germination. I didn't see that in the food stores. Oh, these are seeds. Diseases. Mildew. Powdery and downy. Bacterial wilt. Crown and foot rot. Ew. You can get diseases from this thing? What's all this? Blue something. He's got like, yeah. He's got stuff. He's got seeds and fertilizer and stuff. Soil. I don't like the flopping around. Guys may have noticed. Paper. Hi, Andrew. Sorry you couldn't be here for the dedication ceremony, but it was really lovely. Even Nicholas seemed moved. We found your grandmother's entry. Here's a photo. We'll visit together when you're home. Love you, Mark. That's his husband's name, Mark. Cards. What does it say? Catchy. I thought it said Pikachu. Alright, so... What else is in here? A book. The Gardens at Versailles. Bethany Winter. Photographs by Tammy Liu. The Gardens at Versailles captures the magic of the breathtaking Jardins du Château de Versailles in the most comprehensive photographic survey to date. Alongside these luminous depictions are shown an extensive history of the gardens, their plans, and the timelines upon which they were developed. This is truly a biography of this beautiful World Heritage Site. The garden's long history is thoroughly collected here for your enjoyment and education. Let's see what's in this drawer. We got weights. Ugh, can barely throw them. Nutrition bars. Barley proteins. Great for workout energy. They got whey powder, strawberry extract, plant proteins, flavors, and salt. Cigarettes! Ew. Chris? I can't read that. Contains 20 flameless disposable cigarettes. Oh, like e-cigs. Do not light, keep away from flame. Oh, an empty one. He ate it, baby. He ate that whole thing. I wonder what this signifies. Oh, I like the little nook over here. That's cute. I think these are my favorite personal quarters now. You could use the light from there as well if you're in the right spot to read from. Snack bites. Oh yeah, I saw those in the food stores before. Dear Mr. Dagyav and Mr. Figueroa, thank you for allowing us to show you and your talented son Nicholas around our cutting-edge campus. As the DEC's leading performing and augmented arts educational institution, AU Buffalo is proud to be the number one destination for talented students like Nicholas, whose ambitions drive them to forge a meaningful career in the arts. You expressed interest in discovering more about financial options to enable your son's education. We are happy to accept loyalty from internationally recognized corporate institutions, including the Venturis family of corporate entities. Oh, crap. He cashed in his loyalty, didn't he? To get that bungalow. Man. And if Nicholas is able to secure a position with Amazon Original Content following graduation, we offer tuition forgiveness programs that could result in a college education for Nicholas at effectively no cost to you. Please contact us with any further inquiries as you may have. Malia Crawford, Admissions Chair, Amazon University, Buffalo. Is this Amazon University based on the Amazon that we know? Democratic Eastern Coalition's finest performing arts training campus. Yeah, original content. Like movies on Amazon, made for Amazon. Rated number one in corporate performing arts placement and benefits for the 8th year in a row in Buffalo. Papa Bear! Lamp. Okay. Homework is more important than fun. Love, Nicholas. Have a good year in space. Oh, that's what he says. That's how you see old dad, huh? Papa Bear. The Tibetan people. Mapplethorpe's commercial and personal works. Beauty and the Devil. Nero Wolf's Orchids. Herba Salada. Raising a happy, ethical, respectful, optimistic, hardworking child. Yeah, that's not a long title. Tiger Year Insights. Oh, we know who that is now. Shiwa Dagab. The fact that there's this thing around it. I think it's something like, I don't know. It's like a meta thing. I don't know. The History of the Tibetan Genocide. Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? Excellent. Yeah. Oh, Philip K. Dick, yeah. The Story of Coffee. Infinite Jest. David Foster Wallace. Oh, I can't remember this one. We got Hamlet, Mapplethorpe, Enviable Nobility. Oh, cool. Chang Yi, Moon Goddess. I like that. Oh, seen that? And I did look in here, yes. This bathroom. It's realistic how they give everything bathrooms. Everyone bathrooms. Peppermint, clove. Yeah. The fourth book in Nina Iyer's best-selling worship series, Thayam, places heroine Pooja and her bow-wielding sister Sapna in Kola, a small town in eastern Kalinga, where they hope to rest and prepare for their meeting with the powerful Garuda, Mio. Huh. However, Pooja and Sapna find themselves in the midst of a pious ceremony of blessings, which at first seems so beautiful and harmless until something took notice. Diane. Nina Iyer was born in Hat Yai, Thailand. She has written over 22 novels. Her first was Hand of the Rakshasa in 2068. Rakshasa is like a tiger or a lion person. I think it's a tiger. I can have that on. Sanitize. Must sanitize. Thank you. Okay, so this is quarters. I throw everything around but turn the lights off after me. So I've seen everything up here, but as we see there's a downstairs, but I don't think I can get in there. Did I put that in? Wait. Can I go back and see him push the numbers? I should be able to. Too late.
Hold on, I need to ask you.
Are you okay?
Evie!
Nope, I'm not.
I didn't even see him press it. Is it 6?
Nope, I'm not.
Okay.
I thought he pressed it and put 6 there, because I thought I deleted all that. So... if I could find out that number... that's just food. How about 2052? Tibetan Genocide. He wants to memorialize it. He might do so in his own way. See, now we can see her name. Now we know it's Shiwa. And that... and, well, yeah. We didn't know who it was before. Not sure I opened that before. So what was it? 2052? Try it. If you're so smart and so clever, if that's it. Of course, that might not be it. I don't know. No, damn it. I typed it right, too, right? 2052. Damn it. That's too obvious. What? Can I look at any of this stuff? What is all this? I can't mess with this stuff. Machinery. That goes out. So it might be in his personal quarters. That's a plate. Looking for more papers. Which I just threw around with wild abandon. 2068? It's not personal. But where did I find that paper that told him how he invested in that stuff? I guess I'll just try 2068 just to... eliminate it. 2068, Hand of the Rakshasa. Don't think that's it, but you never know. Always wonder if something might be in printed on the inside or something. 2068. Nope. I never checked the bioscan records access. Ew, mushrooms. Look. But you gotta eat what you can eat, right? Yeah, where's that note? Oh, it's here? Maybe it's here. ...2086 is his license issue date. His date of birth. I'm gonna write that down. I'll mess around with that. I don't know. Because you figure all the hints would be somewhere around here, right? 07, 12, 20, 46, and then his license is 2206, 2086. Oh, so he got when he was 40. Yeah, doomed. He could have used these credits, this loyalty, to help his kids go through school. But instead, he put in the... He changed it to money and put it in this employee investment plan. But then it was outlawed because it can't be automated, so now he can't use that money. Bungalow 0182 and 20... I really doubt it's 2088. You make money every time, but there's going to be no passengers because... It's not legal. That's where I saw it. Oh, this! This is, yeah. 0281. That is going to be the first one I try. That seems the most likely. It's just sticking right out there. I remember seeing that, and then I forgot about it. So, yeah, I hope I get down there. Let's see. We could finish out the... botany section. 0281. Nice. Sweet. So I got to play the rest of that conversation. He smokes down here, apparently. Yep, use cigarettes. He's under a lot of stress because... of his failed investment. That's gotta be tough. That's a lot of frickin' money. Oh, well, here's his oxygen supply. Oh wow, we were severely low. As of 2 days ago. Why does it look like it gets... today? It gets slightly higher? Is it because less people are using oxygen? But that really... Oh, it means now. Because only I'm here. But what would be replenishing the oxygen, right? I'm not replenishing... Unless the plant life is and they aren't because they aren't consuming it. That makes sense. Algae population. Yeah, that went way down. Oxygen production. Right, so the production started going up a little bit because everyone's either in cryo or dead, so they aren't using oxygen. Makes sense. Okay. So I think that's all that's in this area. So I'll just rewind and listen to the rest.
What do you want?
Nope, I'm not.
Okay. Huh. What do you want to talk
about? That was him putting in the digits.
I can't. This is all crazy.
But you said you...
I know. I don't know what I said. But I... What was I supposed to say? You all pressured me.
Andrew.
They really expect us to climb into some jury-rigged thing and ride it through space? Just because VT might not come pick us up. It's insane. And first, we all have to get in cryo just for the privilege... Well, some of us do.
Andrew, I don't know what to say. They do not need us. They need you.
Well, I'm not doing it. I'm not getting in cryo. I'm going to be the same one here.
But they wanted him to.
Nobody even considered that VT might come pick us up in time if we just wait. Nobody even considered it.
Listen, just... Don't talk to anybody else about this for now, okay? And if I were to call the crew into medical, you'd show up, right?
I guess it depends what it is.
Okay. Just... Give me a little time.
So is it him that I'm going to,
Hey, Odin?
Be looking
yes,
at...
Yes, Andrew?
Records?
What should I do?
Still got a while.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I just want to go home.
I understand.
Do you?
Eat that I do.
Can you tell me the average time it's taken VT to send an evac crew to investigate situations like this?
The average time between a remote facility losing ground contact and an investigative crew arriving on site is 98.4 hours.
Whoa, that's
God
a long...
damn it.
That's a long time.
Please try not to be worried, Andrew.
Easier said than done.
That's easy for you to say. You don't have lungs.
Huh.
So, what do you think we should do?
Standard operating procedure requires all crew to engage cryogenic hibernation until help arrives.
Yeah, you know people die in cryo, right?
I know. Sometimes.
If we don't make it out of this, can you deliver a message to my family?
I will do everything in my power.
Okay.
So creepy.
I'll send you something later, all right?
Of course.
It is him, okay. I was hoping. Captured 3 days ago. Fouled? From Mark Figueroa. Reed, just checking in about your renewal. Andrew, I'm not talking about who's paying the bills. I'm talking about Nicholas. Blah, blah. See you every 4 months, and that's not even taking my feelings into account, which I'll just set aside for now. You might not think he's showing it, but Nicholas really wishes you were here. Listen, if you make it, if you back out of your contract renewal, we'll figure out a way to make it work. You know my parents did well in the currency crash. My dad always says, and we're not going to find out what that is, I just want you home. From Andrew. Relying on your parents' charity is your solution? I'm building equity up here. My loyalty will pay for Nicholas's school, and if I back out of this contract, we'll lose all that, and I am not something-something. Don't appreciate this emotional sabotage when you know something. Really getting hard not to feel unappreciated. From Andrew again. Listen, I'm sorry, I just... blah blah. Connection lost, message unsent. Attempting to resend. Aw. You don't get stuck like that. Your apology never gets through. Message with Evie St. James. So Andrew says, I guess we should just carry on as normal? Evie says, we don't have much time. We need to make a contingency plan. Andrew says, but VT is supposed to come pick us up, right? Within 24 hours? Evie says, listen, just blah blah. Increase our oxygen supply in the short term. If worse came to worst. Message with Natalie. Andrew says, there's really no way of getting a signal out? There must be something you haven't tried yet. Natalie says, in all caps, no, Andrew, all comms are routed through a secured VT laser array, and it's been destroyed, and the redundancies were destroyed. Stop messaging me. Oops. So he's just hanging out here, thinking, trying to figure it all out. He's looking at the oxygen Stats?
Well, looks like this'll work. Give us a few extra hours anyway. Thanks, Odin. Okay,
and
Evie,
then it comes up up here.
Hello? Guess I'll catch up with y'all later then.
And that's that. That's it for the botany area. Data process complete. Luckily, even with the attempted data wipe, Odin appears to be mentally intact, just dormant. We're close to having a full picture of the data structure. Alright, missed this. It looks like someone tried to wipe all the AR crew records from the station, but a few couldn't be deleted. System shows the ones left behind were being accessed at the time of the wipe. Got it. Expecting that. Subcontractor Ferrier, proceed immediately to the engineering module. Once AI data is transferred from all modules, you must also secure and return the AI's physical processing medium. The latter requirement is of the highest priority. Right. Biomedical engineering. Okay. So I guess we still can't get into cryogenics? Yeah, I've been playing this for straight 4 hours. Very interesting. I'm about to sign off though. Now leaving biomedical module. I just want to see if cryogenics is at all accessible. Then I'll make a decision whether I want to go there instead. Do they want us to go to engineering? I'd really like to see what happened to these people, if they're still alive in there. Because we don't know what happened in the last... We don't know what happened yesterday. Or possibly all of 2 days ago. Yeah, access denied. We still can't get in there. I can look. Or try, anyway. There and there. These are the pods, the cryopods. And there's more over here. Engineering. Engineering access. Right. So I gotta go to sleep. I'd love to keep playing, but I gotta go to bed now. So thanks so much for watching. Tune back for the next episode when we go into engineering. Thanks again, guys. See you in the next one. And always, seek adventure.